Hello all, welcome to this video on linear algebra. Today we'll be discussing about reduced row echelon form, minus one trick and how to calculate inverse using Gaussian elimination. In the previous video, I have discussed on how to solve a system of linear equations using row echelon form. An equation system is in reduced row echelon form or row canonical form if it is in row echelon form, every pivot is 1, and the pivot is the only non-zero entry in its column. The reduced row echelon form play an important role to determine the general solution for a system of linear equations in a straightforward way. Now we'll see an example problem where we have to verify whether the matrix given is in reduced row echelon form and find all its solutions. By seeing the matrix, it's clear that it is already in its simplest form, which is in row echelon form. Also, the pivot values are 1, and the pivot is the only non-zero element in the corresponding column. This means that the matrix A is in reduced row echelon form. The key idea for finding the solutions for Ax equal to 0 is to look at the non-pivot columns, which will we need to express as a linear combination of pivot columns. The reduced row echelon form makes this relatively straightforward, and we express the non-pivot columns in terms of sums and multiples of the pivot columns that are on the left. The second column is 3 times of the first column. Therefore, to obtain 0, we need to subtract the second column from 3 times of the first column, as shown here. Then we'll take the indices of columns that are present here, which are C1 and C2. The index values are 3 and minus 1. Since the columns C3, C4 and C5 are not present, their indices will be taken as 0. Hence, we obtain the vector 3 minus 1, 0, 0, 0. Since any multiple of this vector is a multiple of this set of linear equations, we'll multiply it with the scalar lambda 1. Similarly, for the fifth column, it can be represented as 3 times the first column, 9 times the third column and minus 4 times the fourth column, which is represented as this. Since the column C2 is absent, its index is taken as 0. Hence, we obtain the vector 3, 0, 9, minus 4, minus 1. Since all multiples of this vector 2 is a solution to the set of linear equations, I'll multiply it by another scalar lambda 2. In the end, we are still solving a homogeneous equation system. To summarize, all the solutions of Ax equal to 0 are given by x element of r raised to 5, where x is equal to lambda 1 of 3 minus 1, 0, 0, 0, plus lambda 2 of 3, 0, 9, minus 4, minus 1, where lambda 1 and lambda 2 are real numbers. Now we'll see about minus 1 trick. Here we introduce a practical trick for reading out the solutions x of a homogeneous system of linear equations Ax equal to 0. To start, we assume that A is in reduced row echelon form without any rows that just contain zeros as given here, where the asterisk sign can be an arbitrary real number with the constraints that the first non-zero entry per row must be 1 and all the other entries in the corresponding columns must be 0. The columns J1, J2, etc., JK, with the pivots marked as bold, are the standard unit vectors. We extend this matrix into an n by n matrix, tilde A, by adding n minus k rows of the form as given here, so that the diagonal of the augmented matrix, tilde A, contains either 1 or minus 1. Then the columns of tilde A that contain minus 1 as pivots are solutions of the homogeneous equation system Ax equal to 0. To be more precise, these columns form the basis of the solution space of Ax equal to 0, also known as kernel or null space. Now we'll see an example of the same. Here we have a matrix A which is already in reduced row echelon form. We now augment this matrix into a 5x5 matrix by adding rows of the form as discussed before. At the places where the pivots on the diagonal are missing, that is in columns 2 and 5. We'll insert rows at the second position and the fifth position so that minus 1 element will come in the second and the fifth columns. The resultant tilde A matrix looks like this. From this form, we can immediately read out the solutions of Ax equal to 0 by taking the columns of tilde A, which contain minus 1 on their diagonal, that is columns 2 and 5. Hence, the solution is x element of R raised to 5, where x is equal to lambda 1 of 3 minus 1, 0, 0, 0, plus lambda 2 times 3, 0, 9, minus 4, minus 1, where lambda 1 and lambda 2 are real numbers. Now we'll see how to calculate the inverse. To compute the inverse of A, we need to find a matrix X that satisfies Ax equal to I. Then X is equal to A inverse. We can write this down as a set of simultaneous linear equations Ax equal to I, where we solve for X, which consists of vectors x1, x2, etc., xn. We use the augmented matrix notation for a compact representation of this set of system of linear equations and obtain A slash identity matrix, which will be finally transformed into I slash A inverse. This means that if we bring the augmented equation system into reduced row echelon form, we can read out the inverse on the right hand side of the equation system. Hence, determining the inverse of a matrix is equivalent to solving systems of linear equations. Now we'll solve a problem to calculate the inverse matrix by Gaussian elimination. First, we'll write down the augmented matrix form, which is A slash IN. So our aim here is to convert the matrix A on the LHS into identity matrix. Now the property of an identity matrix is that it has ones along the diagonal spaces and the rest of the elements are zero. So we'll deal by taking one column each and converting them into an identity matrix form. So I'll take the first column. Except the first element, all other elements should be zero. So for that, I'll perform the following elementary transformation. I'll subtract the second row from the first row so that I will get a zero in this position as given here. Then I'll subtract the third row from the first row, so I'll get a zero in this position as given here. Then I'll subtract the fourth row from the first row, so I'll get a zero in this position. Now I've converted the first column into an identity matrix form. Next, I'll take the second column. The first element is already 0 and the second element is 1. Now, I'll have to convert the third and the fourth elements to 0. For that, I will subtract 2 times of R2 from R3. So, I'll get a 0 here. Similarly, I'll subtract R4 from R2, so I will get a 0 here. Now I've completed the second column. Now I'll move on to the third column. In the third column, I will subtract 2 times of R4 from R3, so I will get a 0 here. Then I will add R2 and R3. Again, I will get a 0 here. Then I'll subtract R1 and R3, again resulting in a 0 in this place. You'll see that there is a 2 present in this column. We'll deal with it later. Now we'll move on to the last column. There, first of all, I'll subtract the rows R1 and R4 so that I'll get a 0 here. Then I will add R2 and R4, so I will get a 0 here. Then I'll add R3 and R4, so I'll get another 0 here. Note that all the transformations performed on the LHS will also be done in the RHS. When we examine the third row, we find that all the elements are multiples of 2. So I am dividing the third row by 2, which will result in this matrix. Then I need to change the negative sign of this element in this matrix. So I'll multiply it by negative 1. It is row 4 is multiplied by negative 1, which results in this matrix. From this, I can take A inverse from the right hand side since I have the identity matrix on the left hand side. So A inverse will be this matrix. We can verify that this is indeed the inverse by performing a multiplication of A and A inverse, and we observe that it gives us the identity matrix I4. That's all for now. Thank you. Thank you for watching.